I'm Nisha Siriparabhu and I welcome you all back to Nisha's Diabetic Kitchen. For a couple of years, I've developed this habit of undergoing a regular health checkup. But for last 2-3 times, my health reports were quite shocking because my calcium levels are drastically falling down. Well, I was just out of concern having a chat with one of my auntie who was in her late 70s. So she advised me that instead of popping in calcium supplements, I should start consuming a bowl of Makhana every day. Initially it was very difficult for me to have Makhana because it's a very tasteless seed. But again, I found out a way and I started consuming it every day in a form of a Bhel. And surprisingly, my calcium levels this time came out perfectly intact. So today's my recipe is Bhel, which I'm going to make using Makhana and peanuts. Well, makhane, it's popularly known as lotus seeds or fox seeds. It's a good carbohydrate, extremely fibrous, low in sodium, and of course, it's very low in glycemic index. And hence, every diabetic should include in their diet chart. And coming to peanuts in small portions, again, it is recommended for diabetics because of its low glycemic index. If you are in the habit of having butter, I would suggest that you replace it with peanut butter because peanut butter along with any carbohydrate, it definitely helps in keeping the sugar levels low. So what are we waiting for? Let's go into the kitchen and check out how to make this mouth-watering Bhel. And I'm sure you're definitely going to thank me for this. So let's go into the kitchen. Thank you so much. So these are the ingredients that we need for makhane peanut Bhel. Now this is one bowl of makhane, lotus seeds or fox seeds, whatever you call it. Now this I have dry roasted it, okay. If you press this, this kind of sound should come. That means it's really very nicely done. It's very crispy. Now this is a half bowl of peanut. Now peanut also I have dry roasted it and this is also very crispy. Now if you want, you can use half spoon ghee for roasting this two separately, okay, but I have not used it. Now this is 1 spoon of tomato ketchup, 2 green chilies finely chopped, then half spoon of chaat masala, salt as per your taste, half lemon for garnishing, 1 strand of coriander chopped finely again for garnishing, this is green chutney. Then this is half cucumber, which I have chopped very nicely. Half onion, again chopped very nicely. 1 small tomato, chopped again very finely. And this is 1 small carrot. Now carrot I haven't cut, I have grated it. Because the pieces usually the kids they don't like. And I also personally don't like, okay. Now coming to this chutney decides the taste of our Bhel. Now how are you going to make this is, you will take 2 green chilies. 1 strand of coriander, half capsicum, half tomato and 4 garlic cloves. Everything put it in the blender, add salt and cumin powder and our green chutney is ready. Now our next step is we are going to take a big bowl, put everything together, toss it very well and our makhane peanut Bhel will be ready, which we are going to serve instantly. So I have nicely tossed this everything. It's very nicely mixed. Okay, now we are going to empty it into a bowl and this has to be instantly served. Oh my god, my mouth is watering so very much. After this video I am going to pounce on this yummy Bhel. So here it comes, our makhane peanut Bhel, which is spicy, tangy, very 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 yummy. So what are you waiting for? Go into the kitchen and try it out right now. So please do give me your feedback and
Of course, do not forget to subscribe to Nisha's Diabetic Kitchen. Thank you so much.